Welcome to Business Analytics Using Forecasting. I'm Galit Shmueli. In this video, we're going to start talking about linear regression. You've seen linear regression in a basic statistics course that you've taken, but you've seen it used for a different goal than what we're talking about in this video. Specifically, it's going to be the difference between using regression for descriptive modeling and for forecasting. Linear regression is very popular for modeling cross-sectional data. For example, if we're trying to model the price of used cars using different features of the car, then I might build a model of the form used car price is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 times the age of the car plus beta 2 times mileage and so forth. How would I use regression? Well, first I would get a sample of used cars. And then I would use their data on their different features and on their prices to estimate the model. Next, I would test the model assumptions to make sure there are no problematic violations. And lastly, when I'm happy, I will use this model to make inference about the entire population of cars of interest. Here is an example. Suppose that we have a sample of used Toyota Corolla cars. For each car, we have the price it sold for, which is our outcome variable of interest. We also have information on different features of the car, such as its mileage, its color, the type of fuel it uses, and more. The car features will be our independent variables. We then fit a linear regression to our sample using some software. The output will look something like the one shown here. We see the list of independent variables in the model and their corresponding coefficients. These are the beta coefficients that were estimated by the software. We also get standard errors, which tell us about variation due to taking a sample. The p-values are used for inferring the effects of each car feature to the population of cars. We also typically get measures of overall relationship. The R-square, the standard error of estimate, these give us an idea of how much variability in prices is explained by the car features. However, when we're going to be using regression for time series forecasting, it's going to be a completely different story. Now let's consider a time series context where we have the monthly average car price and we're trying to forecast the monthly average price in the future. Notice that the independent variables now are not car features, but rather time series patterns such as trend and seasonality. The entire process now is going to look different. Firstly, our data are going to be time series. Next, we're going to partition our series into training and validation periods. Then we can estimate our model only using the training period, and we'll evaluate the predictive performance on the validation period. Lastly, when we're done, we can use this model for generating forecasts for future periods. Here's an example of an output from a forecasting model using regression. You can see that our predictors here, the independent variables, are not the typical features that we saw earlier on. We also see that we're using the training and validation scoring and metrics to evaluate performance, and we have our performance charts as well. Here, we're no longer looking so much at R-squares or p-values. Instead, we're going to be focusing on the actual forecasts and on their predictive performance. The important piece to remember here is that although we're using the same tool, linear regression, when we're using it for time series forecasting, it's used in a completely different way than we use it in cross-sectional. Not only are we using different data, but the whole way we're building the model and evaluating the model is going to be different. First of all, the predictors now are going to be temporal patterns. Secondly, we're going to be estimating our model only from the training period. Thirdly, we're going to use our model eventually to forecast future values. And finally, we're going to evaluate performance in terms of predictive power and not in terms of model fit.